हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू जीके टुडे। आई एम पलक खंडेलवाल। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग टॉप एमसीक्यू ऑन बैंकिंग, फाइनेंस एंड इकोनॉमी, करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ 8 जनवरी 2022। दी सीरीज इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर ऑल बैंकिंग एग्जाम एस्पिरेंट्स। ओके, सो नाउ स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। रिसेंटली आरबीआई एक्सटेंडेड डेडलाइन फॉर डैश अपडेट टिल 31 मार्च 2022। सो द करेक्ट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन डी, दैट इज पीरियोडिकल केवाईसी। So recently Reserve Bank of India, also known as RBI, has announced it has extended the deadline for periodic KYC updates by 3 months till March 31st, 2022. Extension in view of prevalent uncertainty due to a new variant of COVID-19, also known as Omicron. Earlierly, deadline for periodic KYC update was December 31st. Okay. So, meanwhile, the government has also extended the deadline for business to file GST annual return for the 2020-2021 fiscal ended March 2021 by 2 months till February 28. GSTR-9 is an annual return to be filed yearly by taxpayer registered under the GST. It consists of details regarding the outwards and inwards supply made or received under different tax heads. So now let's talk about some important takeaways for all competitive exam. Reserve Bank of India founded on 1st April in year 1935. Apart from that, the headquarter of Reserve Bank of India situated in Mumbai in Maharashtra. And also, the governor of RBI is Shri Shaktikant Das. Okay, so now next question is, which credit card firm just partnered with Paytm for card tokenization? So the correct answer of this question is option A, that is SBI Card. So recently, SBI Card and Payment Service has tied up with Paytm for cards tokenization to protect data for the card holders. SBI Card has collaborated with Paytm to enable holders to tokenize their cards on devices and make payments through Paytm. Tokenization refers to masking the original card number by replacing it with a set of unique character terms as token, which secure the customer card's detail when transaction is under process. Currently, only card issue in the Indian territory are enabled on the Paytm network. However, customer may transact using his or her SBI card through the Paytm network in international location. Okay, so now let's talk about some important takeaways for all competitive exam. SBI Card and Payment Service Limited, previously known as SBI Card and Payment Service Private Limited, is a pure play credit card company and payment solution provider in India. SBI Card was launched in October 1998 by State Bank of India. The headquarters of SBI Card situated in Gurugram in Haryana. Now tell me, who is the managing director and CEO of SBI Card? Please write your answer in the comment section. Okay, so now move to the next question. At what rate India will grow financial year 2022-2023 as expected by ICRA rating agency? So the correct answer of this question is option A, that is 9%. ICRA credit rating agency has expected India's real gross domestic product, also known as GDP, will grow with 9% of rate in fiscal year 2022-2023. The Indian economy has grown at 8.4% in second quarter of the current fiscal year. ICRA said the growth momentum is not enough to confirm a change in monetary policy in February 2022 review. The further expectation index continued to display optimums because of improving the overall economic situation. Now, question number 4. Which company signed a contract with Directorate of General Training, also known as DGT, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, to train 6,000 people in the fintech industry over a 3-year of period? So the correct answer of this question is option A, that is Paytm. Recently, the Paytm has entered into MOU with Directorate of General Training and Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. The MOU was signed to train 6,000 individuals for a period of 3 years in the fintech industry. The patents aims to build India's technology ecosystem, which will drive financial inclusion in India. The selected participants will undergo a 6-month training program designed by Paytm and DGT. The participant will gain basic and advanced knowledge of latest fintech product and financial services. Apart from that, they will also be taught professional skills, communication and sales. They will give on-the-job training during this period. Do remember, the headquarters of Paytm situated in Noida in UP. Okay, so now question number 5. Who was appointed chairman of the National Reconstruction Company? So the correct answer of this question is option C, that is Pradeep Shah. Recently, Pradeep Shah was appointed chairman of the National Asset Reconstruction Company. Apart from that, Sanjay Khan, he was appointed chief executive of India Debt Resolution Company, also known as IDRCL, which is privately owned AMC to resolve bad loans acquired by NARCL, also known as National Asset Reconstruction Company. Okay, apart from that, Geeta Gopinath, she was appointed as the IMFS Deputy Managing Director. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope you liked this session. These were the important news and events for today, which are related to the business, economics and financial sector. We meet again with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching and please do not forget to subscribe GK Today.